So let me share my screen. Okay, how to include third party references? Okay, which one? Bootstrap 4, right? Go to downloads, compiled CSS and JS files. 5.1.3,
so we are not taking latest version, normal.
Okay, which version you are taking? 4.1, right? 4.1.3. Okay, we'll go that version only. Which version people you are using? Let me know. I will take the same version. 4.6.1.
4. Yeah, correct. So 4.6.1. Correct.
Okay, I will take the same. One second. Okay, first bootstrap.min.css file. Okay, so if you want to download, you can double down download, or else you can do like this. Okay, save it, control S. Where we need under CSS, right? Assets CSS. So let me give the reference, save it. Okay, min.cs file is done. Next, min.js file, bootstrap.bundle.min.js file. Separated. Okay. This is the JS file, okay? Simply save it. Okay, bootstrap min.js file. We give that name only. We'll not give this bundle, okay? Go to the JS files. We need to give the reference, JavaScript files. Save here, done. One more file is done. Next, what else we need to add? jQuery file also we need to add. Okay, these are the internal references they have. jQuery means which version students added? 3.5.1? Control S, remove this slim or something, jQuery.min.js file, that's it. Where we need to add under JavaScript files, done. Bootstrap files are added. Okay, next, what else? We require image, okay? For this application, everybody's following or not? For this application, once you logged in, sign up, you have to be add this background image. Okay, let us add some background image. Okay, where to add the background images? Yesterday we saved, right? Okay, let me inspect page. So for this one, I'm having the background image. So, okay, this is the URL. Same exactly how we're going to do in a real time. Same thing I'm explaining, follow. If you have any doubts, ask me. Okay, it's came. Yes, that's images. Here we need to add. Okay, login page. Okay. So let me close. So it is come generating bundle. Okay. Meantime, we'll do our logics. Here, login page is created, right? We need to implement login page. Okay. Okay. First, if you are implementing any page, right? First, create a class for the container. We have the two types of container classes. First one is the container and container fluid. Okay, I just using the container fluid for the login page. Next, login required the how many things? Login required how many? Your email and password. Okay.
Two fields.
Input type is equal to email. Input type is equal to email. We're expecting email only, right? Placeholder. Let me add like a placeholder. Instead of the outside, we can able to add inside. Or else, if you want to try outside, you can able to try. So the parent div always, this will be the form group. Next, create a span or a label. What is the thing? Email. Your email. Next, type email. Done. So this element should contain the which class? Form control. Next, I need to create type password. Okay. Enter email. We'll keep like this one. Enter email. A simple email. Password, email, password, done. Okay, compilation is going on. Next, you have created a file. Next, what you need to do? You need to add a background image. Yes or no? You need to add a background image. Where to add the background image? Create a SCS file dot bg login hyphen background hyphen image. So how to add an image? Background. First, you need to add URL. Which URL we need to add? This URL, right? Can we add like this?
No, sir. We can't add, sir.
Maybe
at the same time, we can like use blink.
Yep. Yes, we need to add the relative path. How to add a relative path? Mm-hmm. Relative symbol slash, which is under. Once you done this one relative slash, it will come under the home card. It will come under the home card. So this will be relative. Now you need to go to the SRC, and then you need to go to the assets, images, SRC slash. Yeah, somebody saying something.
Images. Yes.
Assets slash images slash which image? This is the image. Okay. Which the type of, which type? It is the type of PNG image. How to check that one? Right click, properties. When I downloaded, right, I have seen that one. This is a PNG image. Okay, PNG file. .png. Done. So you need to give this reference. Compile successfully. Let us launch. Okay, page is loaded, but where is my login page? How to give a reference on login page? New ones, because every day we can able to give the reference, right? You people will answer. Can able to try new ones, new people. Rajagopal. So Rajagopal, here I have just created application. So I need to load a login page here. How I can able to add? Rajagopal, are you there, right?
Yes. Yes, I'm sure. You can add it to the app root model. App root component.
Yeah.
App root component.
Okay. Which I need to use? Yeah, rooting. Yeah, module. Yeah, component, or which one you said? Hello. Can you please repeat
After configure to app component HTML.
Yes, app component HTML. You saying that one? We can add here, sir. Please add that one. Okay, let me add. Okay, yeah. App login page. So this one only I need to add, right? Correct. Perfect.
Another thing, configuration, you can add it to app model that we use.
So I can able to see my login page. I can able to see some background image. Next, you are saying that one. This is the one place, but always from the home app component, we will not become. So we need to go for the routing. Yes.
Yeah.
We need to import that one. Yes. Import. We need to import that component dot slash will be the, for example, if you're in the same folder dot slash, if you're in the parent folder dot slash, I am in the same folder, right? Dot slash login slash, okay, login component. Perfect answer. So team, we need to answer, for example, anybody in the interview also, they ask the question, right? I have to give the reference of a component, either if you want to specify inside of a component by using the selector or else in the routing login component. Done. Next, so once it is done, right? Yes, we need to implement.
I have one question.
Yes.
What is the difference between app routing and app model? So you can configure app model also, it can possibly to working.
Yes, in the app model also, if you want to add here, you can able to add. Why? Because here you have the imports in the app routing. Sir, can I will create here something, I code, I will write and add, means it will add, no problem. But simply changing the logic into a file, that's it. Where changing this logic into file, because that also file, this also a module file. Okay, so these are routings. You can able to add this route and you can able to do this one in app modding also. But why? Where simply distribution the responsibility between the files. Okay, between the files, we are adding the responsibilities. So in app component also, I can able to create a login, home, everything based on the directive, which directive, structural directive, ngif, I can able to do. But why we are creating components? Simply giving the responsibility. So here they're adding the simple responsibility, like for this is the routing, simply create a one more module. This is a simple module. There is a no difference between app module, this module, both are the modules only. This is the ng module. The metadata is ng module. Here also ng module only. Okay. But they're simply giving the responsibility.
Okay, it will be starting model.
Here also, if you want, you can do, but the code will be increased. Today you can able to have the 2 to 3 files. Tomorrow have the 200 components of this project, right? Definitely we will get a number of routing files for this one. But we can't able to increase these file always. So that's why the responsibility should be single responsibility. We have the solid principles, right? Single responsibility. We need to follow that one. Angular fully following all the responsibility because it is coming after 2014, right? So Angular follow all the things. It will follow this single responsibility. It will follow the dependency injection. It will follow the interface segregation. Solid principles it will follow. In the solid S for single responsibility, D for dependency injection. Both it will follow. Okay. Next, we'll create a route. So how to create a route? Route is a collection of area objects. Okay. So it will require a path. For a path, which path I need to respond? Login. Comma. For this path, which component I need to add? Login component.
Login.
So, but by default, onload, right? I don't want to be routing as login. Yes, in that situation, you can able to give empty path. Okay. So empty is nothing but a default page, it will go. So in all the technologies, we can able to set a default page will be the path empty here in Angular component, login component. Okay, once you give this one as empty and the route URL it is matching empty, then this login component will be load for you. Okay.
Okay.
But is this load? See here, it will not load. Why? Because so we know all the concepts, sir. Once you created means we have to do that one. But sometimes we will miss the steps, but follow the steps. Once you are implementing the routing, you need to implement the route. After the route, so when we are creating the project first time, right? So if you want to load that routed relevant file, then you need to give a one of the attribute provided by the Angular step 2, which is the thing. What is that attribute? Team.
Router outlet.
Correct. Router outlet. So this is nothing but a Angular tag. So your login page will be loaded in router outlet. Inspect page. Every time have a practice to inspect the page. Once you inspected, right? App login page. See here, app login loaded in a app route. Earlier I said, right, how to inspect or found some page means simply you have some issue and given to you, you know, you don't know the where it is. Mouse down, go to the parent element. Go, this is your parent, this is the parent, this is the parent. Copies, this is the way of digging into the application. Search it, so that file will become okay. Once you're in the search, right, go to this explorer. Once you explore, that is already highlighted, the corresponding HTML page you can able to see. Okay. Okay. Now we'll give the bootstrap references. Okay. Bootstrap references we have not yet given. That's why it is not giving the bootstrap references. So not only the bootstrap, all third party references where you can able to provide. In general, HTML file will be the responsible to take the libraries or the files. Yes or no? So in Angular application, we have only one index.html file. This index.html file will not change daily basis. It will change only once when you are going to include the reference file. Sir, I have one more reference means no, you can't do every time. Okay. So tell me, so how to add a link? First, if you want to add a CSS reference, CSS will be added by using the link. Team, please tell me how to add a CSS reference.
Link to
Nancy? Yeah, you're saying something.
Add it.
Okay. No. So I need to add a this bootstrap references. Here you have downloaded and added our bootstrap libraries, right? Inside of SRC, we have the assets folder. How to give these references? Just asking.
You can add it directly in Angular.json folder.
So link equal to REL equal to style sheets, href equal to, you need to give that path.
Okay. So we can able to do that one is package.json also. First we'll see how to do in a index.html. Okay, by default, everybody having practice this one, right? Okay, which one is the relation? Relation will add later. So I want to add that file path, which I need to use href or src. So everybody is confused with this href and src team.
Href is for bootstrap and src for that term. Yes.
So href dot dot slash. SRC, assets, CSS, bootstrap, min.cs file, relation, style sheet. Next, style sheet. What we need to give? CSS done. Next, we need to give script reference. Okay, for the script, type text slash JavaScript. SRC is equal to dot dot slash src assets JavaScript bootstrap dot min dot js file. Okay, for the script it required the closing tag. jQuery.min.js file. Okay, references are done. Let me refresh. Control F5. Bootstrap.min.js file is failed. Okay, see here. I added some references. Still, it is not loading. Go to the inspect page. Where we need to dig into the network tab. Once refresh, then you can able to get it. So jQuery.min.js file is not loaded. Bootstrap min.dot fail. See here, 404 not found. Bootstrap min.cs file also not found. Why so? Team wise, hello. Everybody feel like movie theater, everybody in silent mode.
Krishna, I asked one question. We can use the TypeScript incident jQuery.
Yes. So here, Krishna given the reference from jQuery, but you are not using the jQuery references. Perfectly correct. Will not use. But Bootstrap min.js file, right? Bootstrap will be used the jQuery. Okay. That's why we're downloading that reference, right, from the Bootstrap site. They're providing the Bootstrap min.js file. Bootstrap min.css file, js file, jQuery file together, right? So otherwise it will not work. See here, even though if you went there, they given the small example. Okay, here there is examples are there. So you need to use the jQuery. Where is that example? See here are the example. This is the example they given, right? Okay, bootstrap min.js file, inside of that one they will require the jQuery files, but in the bootstrap min.js file, this is the JavaScript file. Okay, for this JavaScript file, they will take the jQuery references instead of the document.get element by id set element, but they will use the jQuery syntaxes. Okay, that's why this bootstrap min file will refer the jQuery file. Okay, but in a TypeScript, we will not use that one. Only for the bootstrap to support, we will add that reference. Got it? Otherwise, try that one. Without that one, try it. Few operations will not work until you include it. Okay, but here it's not loading, right? Why so the reason? Can anybody try it? Rajgopal, can I have a try?
Yeah, sure. But file is not get it.
Yeah, file is not down. 404, I'm coming.
It's not proper path.
Okay. In that case, we need to come up with it may not contain the proper path. Okay. So we have the relative paths, right? So instead of the dot dot, we'll use the relative path. So relative will path will be relative SRC. Relative SRC. Yes, right. Relative means it will take the up to here. From here, I need to go to the SRC and then assets. Save this file. No path is came like this. Team, why so silent? We have done this one earlier, right? We already given the reference, right? Vishwanath, Nancy, Ashwini, Uma, you are saying something but not yet answering. In your solution, we have already done this project, right?
Yeah, sir, it's
yeah. You can just see an answer, right? Even though you're not able to answer. Why everybody is so silent? Is seeing something? It is a new thing we're discussing again? No. I'm just showing here a different trial and error methods, how to solve the issue. Okay. Anybody added? Nancy, did you added these references? No.
No, Krishna.
You have not added the bootstrap?
Bootstrap I've added.
Yeah, that is only the right. Here we have the bootstrap issue. Yes.
I've added bootstrap, but not like this. I've added bootstrap, but not like this.
Okay, where you
added? I added like this.
In index.html, but I added direct links from the website.
Yes, that will be wrong thing. No need to add like this. For example, if you take that to, yes, means if you take it will work. Okay, take it two more times, then you will get exact real-time cases how it will be. This will be the case. For example, today it will work, tomorrow they give you a scratch project, right? Screen share stop. Let me share again. So tomorrow they give in that one, then you will get a face issues. What type of issues? These type of issues. So for example, any file, go to the network tab, these files will be failed. Okay, please don't go add. Everyone, please download it. Everyone, please download it. Okay. What happened in the earlier?
And project how... I downloaded this now.
Yes, yes.
Got now, it. Next time I am referring to the URL.
Which is wrong. Don't refer. Okay. Yes. What is the difference between this one, right? Earlier, if you go with this one, so it will treat it as your network path. So path means this HTML page considering your local path. So it will never come. Next, if you're going with relative path also, on the top of that one, HTML creating, that browser creating its own. But the same, if you give the relative path in a server, means it will work. So server, they will configure, okay? So that's why it is, you need to simply add assets, because assets will be the same folder. Please don't go with that. If you add that one, then it will work. We need to go different ways. We need to try it. Got it? So our login page is done. Our login page is done. Yes, somebody asked a question. Yeah, Rajgopal. You're asking something? Okay, fine. So,
hello?
Yes. Hello? Yeah, I can hear.
In Angular, the JSON files you can directly configure to bootstrap CSS model.
Come again.
Angular.json.
Okay, you want to go with angular.json file?
Yes. Here will be configured to every CSS.
Yes.
Style object is there now. So
yes.
You can directly configure it here.
Yes, here in the styles, you can able to configure here. If you want to the script, you can able to configure here. Yes, that's images you have there, right? You can able to configure here.
Why you configure to index that HTML? You can directly configure.
No. In a situation, you can able to do different ways, right? I'm showing the one way. This is not about why here, not there. If I configure there, then we'll get one more different question. Why can't here? Okay, we can configure here and we can able to add here as well. Okay, if you first day itself directly, if you're digging to this angular.json file, that people will be confused tomorrow, they will not become. Got it? So first we need to go step by step. The first step, we can able to simply use the HTML file to configure. So later, once you become a perfect here, right, then we'll go and dig into this JSON files. Okay. JSON files. This JSON we already covered in our basic phase one. We have already covered that one. What is angular.json, package.json? Package.json will have the references of the versions, right? Next, angular.json will have the references for your specific folder. For example, you have the any JS files. For example, once you generate application, how many JS files will be created? Go to the network, polyfill vendor, min.js files will be created, but it will not loaded, correct? So it will be load from here. All the references will be give. Okay, so that's why I'm taking the step by step. Directly jump into there, the students will be confused.
Yeah, okay.
Next, one more the thing. So here you given the references. Next, the order of reference also important. So Bootstrap will be depend on the jQuery, but you are giving this one, right? Always proper order. Let us go with some proper order. Even though whatever it is downloaded, leave it first. CS, jQuery, Bootstrap. Go proper order every time.
CSS. Okay.
So this is our container, right? This is the image. We'll increase height. Okay, so we'll increase height. Let us add some style. Where we need to add? Yes, here we need to add style. So for every situation, Raji Gopal, we can able to handle 2 to 3 ways. Every situation. Okay, I'm showing the few situations I'm taking. I'm showing the students, okay, in this situation we need to do. In the later same situation is coming, right? So earlier we have seen this one, we can able to do this one in this way also. So if you go that one, then instead of one day, you can able to have the 30 days to complete all the topics. Got it?
Yes.
For example, if you want to communicate between the components, different ways, parent child, view child, next template reference variable, next reactive form type, different ways are there. Style height, let me add. Hundred VH, you are getting scroll, right? Let us go with the 90. Okay, done. So our page is ready. Next, what we need to add? We need to add
submit button,
type button. So we seen in the Bootstrap, how many classes are there for button?
Seven types. access.
We have the 7 types are there. Primary, secondary, warning, error, info, like that. Okay. And then we need to give value is equal to login.
Submit.
Login. We don't want to submit, right? You want to login. Okay. Yes. Login. Next. Email, password, and then you can able to login. Okay. Next, login is done. If you want to login, you require the registration page. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. How to implement the registration page? Okay. In the Monday session, we'll see about this registration page. Okay. We'll develop this registration by using the reactive forms directly. In Angular, we're having the concept of reactive forms. Everyone will confuse this reactive form. Yes, right? So, whoever the doubts earlier session also, come for. Don't miss this one. Reactive forms. Okay. What is the difference? How many types of forms are there? Basically, what is a form?
We have two types of forms.
Yes, what is a form?
Different template types. And a form is like where we fill in information.
Where we see something, the UI website.
Yes, sir.
Form UI website. Which gives correct information about the user.
Yes. So form in the sense what you can able to see in the top of the user UI with the interface, user interface, that will be become your form. These forms, the controls, we can able to define in two ways. First one is the template driven form. Second one is the reactive forms. So in the template driven forms, we are going with the model and then model binding creation. Everybody clear about that one, but everybody confused with the reactive forms. Yes or no? So we'll start with the reactive forms. Login, we'll add one registration here. Once you click on the registration, then you can able to get it. Go into the registration, there you can able to create or add your details. Okay. Okay. Please create this one, even though if I'm not giving the task or not task to you, right? Please create. Okay. Please start on this one. So complete your login. Yes, here you have everyone having this link, right? Please start this. Okay. Login, complete registration. Everybody please do that one. If anybody missed any lag, right?